In this video, I will present an example of implicit differentiation. This is a technique for computing derivatives, which is nothing new. It is just a clever use of chain rule. To understand the benefits of this technique, I will present a problem and solve it in two different ways, so we can compare them. First, using normal differentiation, for lack of a better name. And second, using implicit differentiation. The second method will turn out to be much easier. I want to find the slope of the line tangent to the graph of this equation at the point 1, 4. This equation describes a curve that looks something like this. Let's say that this is the point 1, 4. So here is 1 and here is 4. This is not at scale. Now, notice that this doesn't describe y as a function of x. For the same value of x, I have various values of y. But it doesn't matter. This is nevertheless a nice, smooth curve. And it makes sense to ask about the tangent line to this curve at this point and what the slope of it is. That's what I want to do. The first method to do this is going to be to try to solve explicitly for y. Again, noticing that this is not y as a function of x, so I will get something multivalued. But I only care about what happens near the point 1, 4. I want to solve for y here, and this looks a little bit messy. But if I think of y as the unknown, this is just a quadratic equation. I'm going to make this more apparent by grouping terms that have the same power of y together. This 2y squared is the only term with y squared. And then I have two terms with a single y, which are these two. And then the rest of the terms don't have a y. So a quadratic equation in y, I can solve using the quadratic formula. It's going to be a bit long. Patience, and we'll do it. Okay, and now I can simplify this, group terms that I like, and expand the polynomials and see what happens. I'm going to skip the intermediate steps, but after simplifying the algebra as much as I can, I get this. And not surprisingly, I get a plus minus. So I don't get a function, I get something that is multivalued. We knew this was going to happen. If I look at the graph, I can see where the plus and minus appear. If I were to only keep this part of the graph, the top part, then that corresponds to choosing the plus sign in the square root. And if I were to take the bottom part of the graph, that corresponds to choosing the minus sign in the square root. Since I only care about the point 1, 4, I need to choose the plus sign. So I'll keep the plus sign. And at this moment, we can verify that when x equals 1, if I choose the plus sign, this comes out to be 4. So now I know what I need to do. Since I'm looking for a slope, the slope will be given by the derivative of a function, and the solution will be f prime of 1, where f is the function given by this equation with a plus sign. And the rest is calculations. It's a bit annoying, but if we have to, we can do it. I'm not going to do it because it is tedious, and the second method is going to be so much simpler and is going to avoid a lot of the algebra, so I very much prefer the second method. I am not going to solve for y. Instead, I'm going to work with this equation, and implicitly, every time I see a y, I'm going to think that it stands for a certain function of x. So y equals f of x for a function f, whose form I don't know and I don't need to know. And then I will differentiate implicitly using the chain rule. So if this equation is true, it must also be true that the derivative with respect to x of the left-hand side is equal to the derivative with respect to x of the right-hand side. So let's take the derivative slowly. The derivative of 3x squared is 6x. Now, to take the derivative of 2y squared, remember I'm thinking of this as 2 times a function squared. So using the chain rule, the derivative could be 4y times the derivative of this function. And I'm going to call the derivative y prime, where y prime is sort for dy over dx, because I don't want to write dy over dx all the time. And I'll continue. Minus 4xy, I need to use the product rule. And I get two terms, minus 4, 1, y, minus 4, x, y prime. And these two terms, they both come from here. the derivative of 2x is 2, and the derivative of 8y is 8y prime, the derivative of 11 is 0. And on the right-hand side, the derivative of 0 is simply 0. And there, I have now a relation between x, y, and y prime, which is true at all points of the curve, all of them. But I only care about one point of the curve. I only care about what happens when x equals 1 and y equals 4. So I can now plug those in here, and let's see what I get. And I can now solve for y prime by grouping like terms together. So I get that y prime equals 2, and that's the answer. That's the slope I was looking for. Notice how this second method was so much simpler than the first one. The calculations were faster and easier. And this happens in general. Implicit differentiation is your friend. Don't be afraid of it. Even when we can solve explicitly for y, if we keep our equations implicit, the calculations tend to be much simpler.